Hi, I'm Jared Hillam. Today I want to offer up a challenge to all those that are watching this video. Find something in the room you're in that has never had any data associated to it. Go ahead, look around. Unless you find yourself watching this in the middle of no man's land, chances are that a very high percentage of everything around you has been represented by data at some point in its life cycle. That's pretty amazing, isn't it? So in many ways, you can imagine that our digital world of data is a representation of the physical world around us. And indeed, it would be nearly impossible for organizations to accurately describe themselves if they didn't have access to this type of data today. And just as organizations need to manage their physical assets, they likewise need to manage their data assets. After all, they are a representation of the physical world. And this is the point where I introduce you to something called an ETL tool. ETL stands for Extract, Transform, and Load. Just as its name implies, ETL tools extract data from a source, transform the data while in transit, then it loads the data into a target storage of choice. These movements of data can be scheduled on a regular basis or triggered to occur. The types of projects that ETL tools are used for vary greatly, as these tools are built to be very flexible. Some common projects would be rolling up transaction data for business people to work with, which we commonly call data marts or data warehouses, migrating application data from old systems to new ones, integrating data from recent corporate mergers and acquisitions, and integrating data from external suppliers or partners. The list of possible uses for an ETL tool extends well beyond the scope of this presentation, but hopefully you'll walk away from this video with an appreciation for how critical these systems can become to the day-to-day operation of a business. To highlight life without an ETL tool, imagine having to be an expert at every source of data your organization owns and trying to hand code all the data movement requirements we discussed earlier. Now, here is where I want to provide a warning. When you use an ETL tool, you will marry your organization to it. This is because a large body of logic will be designed in the data movement process, and it will become part of the lifeblood for running your business. So the purchase and use of an ETL tool is a very strategic move, even if it's intended for a small tactical project to begin with. So before you marry yourself to your ETL tool, make sure that you're not painting yourself into a corner, as ETL tool migrations are no small effort. Here are areas that you should focus on in determining which ETL tool to choose. 1. Data connectivity. ETL tools should be able to communicate to any source of data, no matter where it comes from. This is critical. You may not have mainframes in-house today, but all it takes is an acquisition of another organization to all of a sudden need to get access to those types of systems. 2. Performance. Moving and changing data can require some serious processing power, so it's important that your ETL tool can scale with its future data growth. 3. Transformation flexibility. Matching, merging, and changing data is critical. ETL tools should provide these and many other package transformations that allow modifications to be made to the data with a simple drag and drop movement. 4. Data quality. Your data isn't clean. I can guarantee it. You will need support for data profiling and data quality, including the ability to validate addresses. The only way you can leverage your data to deliver information is if your data is consistent and clean. 5. Flexible data acquisition options. Once you have your ETL environment developed, you'll want the flexibility to determine whether your data is acquired on a time interval or based on a trigger. This also means that you'll want the flexibility to determine what data gets pulled, whether it's just the new data or all the data at once or even a specific subset of data. 6. Committed vendor to ETL. Remember, you're about to marry yourself to a tool. Be sure your spouse is committed to data management and all the activities around it. Intricity partners with its customers to evaluate which tools will best fit their organizations. I recommend you reach out to Intricity and talk with one of our specialists. We can guide your organization in formulating a selection criteria that can ensure a good fit for managing your data over the long run.